Jack Griffin on a mission for power. Prowling through the town at the witching hour. Walks in the lion's den and gauze on his skin. Everybody gawking at him. He just trying to get a spot with nobody bothering him. H.G. Wells, he was intolerant. Call a popped on the trench, top floor to end. Of course they were worried, they scurried to sin. Police in a hurry for him, invisible from chemicals. They couldn't see shit. Shots in the distance from the pistol he gripped. Terrorized the town and attempted to get his old friend Kemp to enlist in his business. Invisible man can rule the world with a quickness, but Kemp snitches to the pig, says Griffin's gonna kill him. So they wait outside the motherfucking building. But Griffin's and Kemp's whip it, and he fucking kills him. Drives him off a cliff with the cackle of a villain. Blood spilling, explosions, bone chilling, snow blowing in the wind. It's still chilly, sneaks away to a barn so it can't be seen visibly. Mentally he's drained from putting strain on the city. Lays in the hay, he sleeps swiftly. Farmer hears him sleeping, calls the pigs quickly. They set the building ablaze from the entry. Griffin had to escape, but it gave him away simply. They shot him and he fell. Instinct on his deathbed, telling Flora of his misery. Mono cane in his brain, he died visibly.
He died visibly. He died visibly.
Name's Jekyll, but you can call me Henry or the Chemist. The fluid that I'm sipping turns these streets into madness. I'm meant to separate the evil from the human psyche, but now my other half is murderous, feeling feisty. Picking fights with myself, so self-absorbed. Mental rank checks are all I can afford. This whole time I capsized my right mind to realize my mental condition cannot be restored. Name's High. It's what you should do. This curious case won't be misconstrued. Jekyll is a lightweight gentleman, see? Murder, 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 make the whole town flee. Busting canes to your skull, no remorse. A dense fog rises from your lifeless corpse. London is cursed from chemical disorder. On the lines of madness, I'm past the border. Wait! Allow me to elaborate. Internal intentions were never to collaborate. I merely meant to mitigate the flaws of the mind. Chemical addiction has rendered me blind. Psychology's saying slipping subtly. The more I start to drink, fading farther from reality. Now I see maybe this cause was in vain. No control of my fate, no control from my brain. Henry is gone, subconscious revolt. Hinges of sanity slip and unbolt. Anger and rage were hidden beneath. Now that he's gone, I feel the relief. The night will be mine as I lurk in the streets. The screams from my victims will be such a treat. Deep down he was I, for years he had lied. No more shall he run from the truth, Mr. Hyde.
Was it a gust that rustled the curtains? Put the window shut and latched. You become uncertain now as the hairs on your neck start to raise. Who's afraid of a nebulous appearance from a guest on the quest beyond the grave? Rubbing your eyes and pale with disbelief. My spirit floating over you got you choking on your speech. Good grief, this must be your phantom of the dead, or a manifestation of all the demons in your head. Either way, I want a piece of your spirit. Hear me wailing dark tales from the cemetery, scary like Bloody Mary appearing. But this is no illusion in the mirror. The moon glows in the window and shows my figure clearer. Menacing revenant, to hell with it. You attempt to run, but the wicked spell is cast upon your skeleton. Once this, it came and left no trace at all. It's as if he evaporated directly through the wall. You weren't expecting that spectral visitor in the midnight hour. I came and took your soul prisoner, and all the while a pitiful whimper's all you can muster. Who? You're dealing with the Ghostbuster.
My body's so weak, limbs gone numb. I can hardly speak with a sandpaper tongue. Death's embrace hangs over my head as I try to retrace the tracks I've tread. The streets are a graveyard, bodies piled high. Stench emanating from the maggots and the flies. Got a quick glimpse of my personal fate. Then I moan and I wince for a death I await. Death awaits me on a pale horse ride to set my soul free with a step and a stride. Approaching me now with his sides held high. Time to reap the rewards of a life passed by. Coughing and gagging, for now is my time to return to the darkness from which I arrived. His eyes look to me so demonic and vague. See, my death's a result of the bubonic plague.
Thank you.
One, two, three, go. You look so good when I took you in. I wanted to wear your skin. The moths on my walls didn't mind at all. Started to scream. Are you
you about a size 14. Puts the lotion on its skin, or else it gives the pose again. Puts the lotion on its skin, or else it gets the hose again. What the hell? Don't yell from that well. You're scaring my dog to death. I'm using your skin to make a suit, maybe a dress. I got all kinds of thread up in this mess. Put the lotion in the basket. Put the fucking lotion back in the basket. Put the lotion in the basket. Put the fucking lotion back in the basket. Agent Starling, why? Come in, my darling. Have a look around in my basement. That's okay. You'll find nothing down there except a girl who's rather complacent. I'm having a skin party, baby, and you're not fucking invited. Would you fuck me? Cause I'd fuck me so fucking hard. Would you fuck me? Cause I'd fuck me so fucking hard. Goodbye.
Fucked up.